So next part of the antibiotic which act as anti-cancer agents are the actinomycin. So these actinomycins are the group of compounds. They are isolated from species of streptomycin. Okay. So these drugs, actinomycin, they have major two structures, or those two parts in their structure. One is the phenoxyoxazone chromophore and second one is the dipentapeptide portion. So these two portions are generally responsible for their activity. Okay. So the first drug or the prototype of this drug is the actinomycin D. So generally it is known as the dactinomycin. So these are the drugs which are obtained from the various species of streptomycin having these two features in their structures. Now this is the structure of first actinomycin, that is the actinomycin D, dactinomycin. So you can see that this is the peptide part and this is the phenoxazone part. These two are parts are mainly responsible for the binding to the DNA. So next part, the mechanism action of dactinomycin. So as we have told that these are the antibiotics, they are generally act as the intercalating agents. Okay, what is intercalation? So there are two types of groove are there. This is one type of groove, this is second. One is the major groove, another one is the minor groove. So what happens, suppose this is the A and suppose this is the C. So these are the okay, so this is the one strand of DNA, this is the other strand of DNA. So what happens, this drug, this is antibiotic dactinomycin, it intercalates itself between the these two nucleotide bases, that means in between A and C, T and G. So it fit himself in between these two nucleotides, so it comes at this position. So that is the main intercalation effect of the dactinomycin. So when we are giving the dactinomycin, it intercalate in between the DNA, in between these two nucleotide bases. And when they intercalate between these two nucleotide bases, what happens? The distance between A and C increases. So A move some far above side, C move some part to the downside. So due to this, the distance between A and C, it changes. Similarly, distance between T and G, T also changes. Okay, actually the distance between A and C is the fix. Okay, so but due to the, this intercalation of the dactinomycin, the A somewhat move to the upper side, C somewhat move to the downside, so the distance between A and C increases. And when distance between A and C increases, so there one may nucleotide base is present above the A, suppose it is also the C. So the distance between A and C decreases. Okay, again below C there one may be nucleotide bases present, so distance between C and that nucleotide base decreases. And due to the decrease in the distance between the these two nucleotide bases, as well as increase between the distance of two nucleotide bases, the stability of DNA changes and rupture of the DNA takes place. So this dactinomycin is responsible for the intercalation of DNA so that the DNA inhibition takes place. So these are the two parts denoted by the D. So these are the two parts, that is the minor groups where dactinomycin intercalates itself. Okay, it binds to the DNA by this part. So that is the mechanism of action of dactinomycin. Now move to the next class of the anti-cancer agent, that is the organoplatinum complex. So as name indicates, it consists of platinum ions, platinum metal. Okay, so these agents are the examples of these organoplatinum complex. They having the electron deficient metal ion, and actually DNA is the electron rich. So if DNA is electron rich, it will look for the positively charged species. So it act as the nucleophile. Okay. So the metal is electron deficient, the DNA is the electron rich. So when they comes together, that is the organic platinum complex and the electron rich DNA, when they comes together, what that? The bonding between these two takes place. And when the bonding between these two takes place, like nitrogen mustard, the organic platinum complex form a bifunctional and can accept the electrons from two DNA. So they are responsible for the binding to the two DNA. That we have seen in the nitrogen mustard. It is the one nitrogen mustard is responsible for the binding to the 2-7 position of guanine of one DNA or different DNA. Okay. Similarly, this organoplatinum complex, they are the having the electron deficient species. They can attract towards the DNA which is the electron rich. So one part of the organoplatinum complex or the drug is responsible to bind to the one DNA, and the other part of that drug it responsible for the bind to the second DNA. So in this way, the one drug is responsible for the binding to the two DNA. That means one drug is responsible for the accepting electrons from two DNA. So they can damage at a time two DNA. Okay. So one of the example of this organoplatinum complex is cisplatin. Okay, cis means these amine sites are of same side, chlorine are the same side, so they called as the cisplatin. So in the first step, what happens? The one of the chlorine atom, it is removed and the water molecule it binds to the platinum. Okay, so this Cl molecule, Cl minus, it is removed. The water molecule comes in the place of Cl, so it gets H2O. But this H2O, it responsible to get positive charge on the platinum, so this becomes electron deficient species, and our DNA is the electron rich species. Okay, so in the second step, again this chlorine it is removed and another water molecule come in the part place of this one. So you can clearly observe that two chlorine molecules, so the two chlorine atoms, they are eliminated from the platinum, and instead of these two chlorine parts, the water molecule or two water molecule binds to this platinum, and such type of species is called as cisplatin diaquaform. It is the active part, and this active part is responsible for the binding to the N7 position of guanine. Okay, so this water molecule, it is eliminated, so this platinum bind to this part. In second step, this eliminated, this can bind to the this part. So these two water molecules, they are eliminated, and this elimination of two water molecules are responsible. So platinum bind to the this DNA also, it binds to the this DNA also. So in this way, platinum binds to the two DNA, so it inhibit the synthesis of DNA, or it can alkylate the DNA. In this way, this cisplatin is act as the anti-cancer agent. So when one water molecule is present, it is called as monoaqua form. In second step, second chloride also removed, and the second water molecule comes into the bonding with the platinum. So it is called as cisplatin diaqua form. So here one positive charge is present, here two positive charge is present, and it consists of two water molecules. Okay. Now another example for this organoplatinum complex, it is the oxaliplatin. Okay, similar what happens in the cisplatin, similar takes place when the water molecule comes. This water molecule are responsible to break this bond, and when this bond breaks, the water molecule binds directly to the platinum. See that here water molecule it binds to the platinum, and it platinum gets positively charged. So it is called as oxaliplatin monoaqua form. Okay, in second step, this all remove in the form of COO minus, and second water molecule it binds to the platinum. So you can observe that this platinum having two water molecules, so it is called as oxaliplatin diaqua form. When these two water molecules binds to the platinum, it gets plus 2 charges. Okay, so when it comes into contact with the DNA, one of the water molecule, it is removed. The 7 position of guanine binds to platinum. When another DNA or the same DNA comes into contact, Again, this water molecule, it is eliminated, and platinum directly binds to the N7 position of guanine. So in this way, cross-linking takes place. They can bind to the guanine of the same DNA, or they are responsible to bind to the guanine of different DNA. So they are responsible to damage two guanines or the two nucleotide bases at a time. So in this way, this oxaliplatin and the cisplatin, these are the organoplatinum complex which are electron deficient. That means it gets the positive charge. DNA is the electron rich species, so the force of attraction between these two takes place. So the bonding between the DNA and organoplatinum complex takes place. Okay. So the next classification of anti-cancer agent, it includes the histone deacetylase inhibitors. So examples of romidepsin and vorinostat. So these are the two examples which comes under this histone deacetylase inhibitor. So what is the histone? Histone is the proteins around which the DNA coiling takes place. Okay. So around that histone, there is a coiling of DNA takes place. When DNA is in the coil form, it does not produce any expression. That means it will not produce transcription translation process and a protein biosynthesis. So in this way, it is in the coiling form. In here, it is in uncoiling form. So when DNA is present in the uncoiled form, it can responsible to produce the transcription translation process, that is the gene expression, to synthesize the different proteins. Okay, that is a normal condition. The balance between these two takes place. Okay, so histone deacetylase acetylation, what it does, histone deacetylase, it causes the deacetylation of this. When deacetylation of this takes place, uncoiling of DNA takes place. So this uncoiling, it will result into the gene expression. Again, histone acetylation takes place. This acetylation is responsible for the coiling. If coiling takes place, there is no gene expression takes place. So that is the normal process going on between the histone deacetylation and histone acetylation. So that is a normal cell. So when in case of the tumor cell, what happens? You can check this part increases. That is the uncoiling part. And when uncoiling part increases, the protein biosynthesis can be synthesized in more amount. And when the protein biosynthesis synthesized in more amounts, the more enzymes, more machinery, more requirement of cell division can be synthesized. And when this requirement increases, the rate of cell division increases. So that is actually takes place in the tumor cell. That is the more growth of the cell takes place. Okay, so why it is takes place? Because of uncoiling. And when uncoiling takes place, it can be responsible for the gene expression. If it is present in the coiling form, it will not produce the gene expression. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to bring this process to the normal. We have to decrease this part. Okay, that means we have to increase the coiling of cell instead of uncoiling. So when we are giving the enzyme histone deacetylase inhibitor, so it does not causes the deacetylation, so the coiling remains as it is. And due to the coiling, what happens? It will not produce the gene expression. That means the protein biosynthesis will not synthesize. Okay. So to carry out the gene expression, cell must control the coiling and uncoiling part which are present around the histone. And this can be done with the help of histone acetyl transferase, that is the HAT, and the histone deacetylation. Okay. So these are the two enzymes which are responsible for the coiling and uncoiling. If we inhibit the enzyme histone deacetylase, what happens? The coiling remains as it is. And due to the coiling, what happens? There is no gene expression, no protein biosynthesis. The cell growth does not take place. So just go through it. Histone acetyl transferase, which acetylates the lysine residue on histone. And if it acetylates lysine residue of histone, it will becomes less compact. Okay. And deacetylation or the histone deacetylase, what it does, it removes the acetyl group from the lysine residue and leading to the formation of
silence chromatin. That means due to the coiling part, it will not produce the gene expression. So this acetylation is responsible, or the acetylation takes place of lysine part which is present. Okay, so deacetylation removes the acetyl group from the lysine. Acetylase, transferase added the acetyl group to the lysine. So these are the difference between these two examples. Okay, if histone deacetylase inhibitors they are given, they will not remove the acetyl group from the lysine. Hence, the coiling remains as it is, and hence there is no synthesis of protein takes place. Now, next part, that is the tyrosine kinase inhibitors. For example, imatinib, dasatinib, and lapatinib. So tyrosine kinase, as the name indicates, kinase is the responsible for the phosphorylation dephosphorylation process. And if phosphorylation dephosphorylation process, if it is inhibited, so DNA will be not synthesized. Why? Because adenine will be converted into adenosine, that will be converted into adenosine monophosphate, biphosphate, triphosphate. So this addition of phosphate group is can be done with the phosphorylation reaction. And this phosphorylation reaction is carried out by the enzyme kinase. And if kinase is present, then only it can be done. If kinase is inhibited, the phosphorylation of adenosine to monophosphate, diphosphate, triphosphate, or guanosine into the guanosine, monophosphate, diphosphate, triphosphate will not take place. And only this triphosphate form, it will enter into the synthesis of DNA and RNA. Only the guanine is present, it will not enter into the DNA synthesis. Guanosine triphosphate is there, then it will enter into the DNA synthesis. So tyrosine kinase inhibitor inhibits this conversion into the phosphorylation form, and hence it will not enter into the DNA or RNA synthesis. So there is no protein biosynthesis, so there is no growth of the tumor cell takes place. Okay. Tyrosine kinase is the enzyme responsible for the activation of many protein signal reduction. Many proteins by signal transduction. Okay, their inhibitors are typically used as anti-cancer agents for generally myelogenous leukemia or the chronic myelogenous leukemia. Okay, so that is the explanation. If ligand and cell membrane is present, this ligand comes near to the transduction mechanism, then phosphorylation takes place. After phosphorylation, cell proliferation, cell migration, and tumor formation takes place. If enzyme is inhibited, there is no phosphorylation process. So this step, that is the cell proliferation, migration, or the tumor formation, this step decreases. Okay. So the imatinib is a drug which is called as a tyrosine kinase inhibitors. They act as the anti-cancer or anti-tumor cell. They block cancer cells to grow faster. Okay. So this is the structure of imatinib, how kinase domain is there, substrate binds takes place. After binding substrate to the kinase domain, the phosphorylation takes place. So what imatinib does, instead of binding substrate to this yellow color part of the domain, the drug binds to, or the imatinib binds to this domain. So substrate remain as it is. So there is no phosphorylation process, and tumor cell, it cannot proliferate. Similar for the lapatinib, it is generally used for the combination therapy in the treatment of breast cancer. This is dasatinib. It is used in the CML, that is the chronic myelogenous leukemia. Okay.